portion of the message. And really, I'll let you know my intent from the very beginning of the message. Is just to bring us to a place of worship, so we're going to sing that song to bless and worship God. It's a good place to be. And so I'm not going to be extensively long tonight. I simply want to set a platform, and then I want to give us an invitation just to bless the Lord. That's what I want to do this evening. I feel like that's the tug of my heart, what the Spirit of the Lord wants. Amen. Ephesians 1, verse number 3, the Word of God says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ." Now, I know that some folks live from paycheck to paycheck, but wouldn't it be nice tonight if we could each look and sense and feel and know that we are richer than what we thought? To know that you are richer than what you thought. Any of you ever at the season beginning, maybe you put your coat on and you slip your hand in that coat and you find $5? Or, you know, as a child, maybe pulling the cushions out of the chair and finding some change. My wife and I, her folks were here, so we were trying to sort through some things and that we don't often get time to focus on together. Now, I was going through a box this routine, and I found a birthday card from my mom. I thought, I'm just going to open this up and look at it. Sister Tiffany, I opened it up, and there was $20 bill. I was richer than what I thought, Brother Josh, yesterday. Amen. I was saving it for something special, Brother Justin, but I forgot about it in the meantime, so I'm richer than what I thought. And so, Brother Doug, what a blessing it is to know that we are richer than what we may think that we are. And so tonight, that's really the crux of what I want to share with you, is you are richer than what you think you are. In West Texas, there was a poor rancher, Ira Yates, who became a millionaire overnight because it was found that on his property there was oil. They have now taken from his property, Brother Eli, over a billion barrels of oil. And this rancher, who was struggling to pay his mortgage and his taxes, now realized he is richer than what he thought he was. Amen. Isn't that a good place to be in? Richer than what you think you are. Amen. If you're a Christian tonight, amen, every child of God, amen, every child of God in here, you are richer than what you can ever imagine and even think that you are. Paul, most of his epistles, when he starts out writing them, he starts out giving a salutation and a greeting to the church or the individual in which he's writing. However, here in Ephesus, it is different as he writes to this church, these Ephesians, and he starts out praising God. In fact, if you were to look at this, the beginning of this, verse number 3 through verse number 14, imagine that. You can take time to look down through verse number 14. When this was originally written, it was one whole sentence, and it consisted of 202 words. That's a sentence, isn't it? Amen. And so here it is. Scholars refer to this as being the praise eulogy. Amen. And Paul, he praises, amen, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. Throughout this beginning, this eulogy, the start, he's praising God. Amen. And he says here in the text that I read, amen, blessed. Blessed means this. Blessed means praised. Praised be God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. It means that he be praised. Blessed be God. Amen. It's a declaration that God is to be blessed. Amen. In his writing, In fact, this same word blessed is found throughout the New Testament. I think it's two other times in Paul's writings, but it's found a total of 8 times in the New Testament. And every time this word blessed is used, it's never given to give honor and glory to man, but it's used to give glory and honor to God. Tonight I'm talking to believers that we are richer than we think we are. We are richer than we think we are. So God is to be blessed. But let's answer this question. Why should God be blessed? The Word of God says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because tonight we are blessed in Christ. And so God is to be blessed. We're blessed in Christ. The Bible says, who have blessed us, that's you and I, blessed us with all spiritual blessings. Listen, way back in the beginning in the Garden of Eden, it was because of one man's sin. Because of one man, sin entered into the human race. And although we have not committed the same sin that Adam committed, we were born in sin. But the Word of God says that God gave us His Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. And because of the gift of Jesus Christ, amen, He has given us eternal life. Amen. Why should we bless God tonight? Amen. Because of the blessings He gave us in Christ. Amen. He has saved us. He has redeemed us because of the cross. As in Adam, all men shall die, but in Christ, all men who accept Him as their Savior shall live. Amen. That is reason to bless the Lord tonight. Amen. Because all spiritual blessings God has given through His Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. How has God blessed us in Christ? With every spiritual blessing. Spiritual blessings are those things that aren't material. We think of being blessed and we're thinking about being rich oftentimes because we have things. Amen. Tonight I'm talking about richer than what we realize that we are. We have all spiritual blessings in Jesus Christ. Amen. God has not merely given us some spiritual blessings, but every spiritual blessing, amen, comes by the product of God's grace. They include several things as we look down through this chapter. Verse number 4, we look and we see that we're adopted. Are you glad that you're adopted into the family of God? That's a spiritual blessing. We look at verse number 5 and 6. Amen. The election is verse number 4. Adoption is 5 and 6. And redemption in verse number 7. And forgiveness in 7. And then the revelation of what God's plan for our life is. In verse number 9 through 10, we have an inheritance in Christ. Verse 11 through 12, we are sealed with the Spirit. Amen. In verse number 13 and 14. Amen. Thank God that we have blessings that come from God. Paul was dealing with some folks. The Bible says, let me jump down and find my verse I want. Well, let me jump back to verse number 11. Let me just look at that first. The Bible says, in whom we also have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of Him who worketh all things after the counsel of His own will. Let me tell you what predestination means. It doesn't mean that God takes Brother Justin, I'll save him, and that He picks someone else, I won't save that person. I'll pick Sister Stacy, but that person, I'm going to God doesn't predestine people to go to heaven or hell. But God has already, Brother Josh, predestined before the foundation of the world that there would be redemption through His Son, Jesus Christ. God made a way for all humanity. They are predestined to have salvation if they will accept it. Praise God. Thank God for His blessings and His promise. The Word of God goes on down to say that He allows us to sit in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. He was dealing with some folks that They were serving the god Artemis, and the temple was built there to this god. Basically, inside the temple, there was a huge rock that was there. They worshiped this god, the huge rock that was there, making reference back to the book of Acts, was probably a meteorite or something that fell from heaven, and it was a rock. And so they began to create a temple, and they worshiped around this rock that fell from heaven. But Paul was saying this. He said, you worship a rock that fell from heaven, but Jesus Christ lifts us up to heavenly places and allows us to sit with Him and enjoy every heavenly blessing that comes from Him. Amen. Paul once again said, amen. Blessed be God the Father, the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. I was thinking about how that God worked and moved in the life of Heather. We know that that's a miracle. We know that we were praying, others were praying. That's a spiritual blessing. I talked with Sister Jan. Her niece was so sick, concerning, not sure what the answer was going to be. Would she live? Would she survive? Would she know her family? What would all... So I said to Sister Jan, I'm encouraged because I know in that same hospital where your niece is, we had a similar situation just weeks ago where we were concerned, what will happen. But if God did it for one, God can do it for another. I don't know the complete story, but I know that God has worked and moved in Kim's life. You know what? Those are spiritual blessings. When we lay our head down on our pillow at night and there's peace in our mind, those are spiritual blessings. When we live in a family where we look at the authority of God's Word and we know how to love one another and treat one another, amen, that's a spiritual blessing. When we realize that the past of our sins have been forgiven, that is a spiritual blessing. When we look at lives of others who maybe the community and the rest of the world has crossed them off as being hopeless, amen, we know that there is hope for those individuals that are dear to our heart because those are spiritual blessings that God gives us. Amen. We know that we've been adopted into the family of God, that when this life is over, amen, it's just the beginning of one eternal with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. If we've accepted Jesus into our heart, that is a blessing that comes from heaven. Amen. Being justified by faith. Thank God that we have spiritual blessings, and not only for those things that are to come, but tonight we have spiritual blessings that we can sit in a heavenly place with Christ. Amen. He comes and He lifts us up and He allows us to abide with Him in His presence. Those are spiritual blessings tonight. I don't need a drug to do that. Amen. I don't need a drink to do that. Amen. All I need is to enter into the presence of God. And that's a spiritual blessing from God. Sit in heavenly places with God. I want you to think about something, and I'll talk about spiritual things, but I want to look at, just in closing, I want to look at some material things. According to the Global Rich List, if your annual income is $20,000, you are in the top 11.6 of the richest people in the world. That's $20,000. If your annual income is $35,000, then you are in the top 6.36% of the richest people in the world. If your annual income is $50,000, then you are in the top 1.78% of the richest people in the world. When we look globally, my friend, we are blessed physically. We're rich. Us folks sitting in this sanctuary tonight, compared on a global scale, we are rich. Amen. We get delusion because of the community that we live in, because of the nature of the environment we live in, but we are rich. On a scale looking globally, we are rich. But I want to tell you, even more than physical things, you and I are rich in Christ tonight. That we would know the election of God, the redemption of God, the adoption of God, the forgiveness of God. That we have an inheritance, that we are sealed with the Spirit of God. Praise God, we are rich tonight. So tonight I want us to do this. My wife will come, just work with us as we work with our girls. It's sometimes a little difficult when we're both trying to do something. But I want us to come tonight. And what I want us to do in closing, and I'm not rushing closing, but I want us to gather in. If Sister Beth would come, I just want us to sing a song of blessing to God. Can we do that tonight? You can start making your way now. Amen. Let's just gather in at the front. Paul said this. He said, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ." We are blessed tonight. And if I can just help change our perspective a little bit this evening. I know that we get tired. All of us do. Schedules and work. Sometimes we look at the things that we don't have. Tonight I'm not asking us to... Yes?
Don't be like this. Speaking on this, that's what you know. Because in another month, I had my front home bill that I've been paying about something like $700 a month just to get a paid off. And it's something, you know, I don't make $3,000 or something like that. But the Lord, I never known before what the Lord had done, and He had done it for me. You know.
Amen.
It's a blessing, you know, how the Lord is letting me have this money so I can get a bunch of payoff.
Praise God.
It's a miracle.
Amen. I know that was a burden on Brother Eli's heart because he had it, along with a very high interest rate that he was not really aware of so much when he took it out. But God, next month you'll have it paid off, brother. Amen. He's been working diligently for several months, haven't you, Brother Eli? The Lord has helped you. The blessings of God.
Father, the Lord can do for you if you put your trust in
Him. Amen. We're blessed tonight. Let's just bless God. Amen. Let's let our soul magnify God in these next few moments. Blessed. Blessed. Be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessing in heavenly places. I'm closing, and I'm sorry to prolong. I wish I could tell you that in every place that I go to visit folks, that I'll get a call, or that folks experience the things of God, but so many people don't live their life intentionally. But when we live our life intentionally and we know what God has done, we're aware of the blessings He gives us. Salvation, amen. Being adopted into a family. Being allowed that in a hectic world to be able to close the door to our closet and separate ourselves to God and sit in a heavenly place. That's a blessing. Let's worship the Lord tonight as we sing.